the sort of skullduggery that is at the back of this amendment and the various amendments that you brought forward at the last minute in order to circumvent the normal process of legislative scrutiny and oversight is precisely what has brought people to the streets this evening, and indeed over the last year or so has brought unprecedented numbers onto the streets in fury and anger, not just at the unfairness and the economic hardship of austerity, which is unbearable for huge numbers of people, which has plunged people into poverty, into greater levels of deprivation, into homelessness, and into all that needless suffering. That's one aspect of the anger and the fury that has led people onto the streets, for Deputy Shatter's information. But the other aspect of it is the utter contempt for democracy. The utter contempt for democracy. The playing fast and loose with the entire democratic process, inadequate as it is in the first place. An election every 5 years where the people you elect can then just shred all the promises they made, are completely unaccountable, and there's nothing the people who voted for them could do about it. As if that isn't bad enough. Even with the limited, utterly limited, form of democracy we have, even with that, you want to subvert it. And this amendment really highlights what you were at. Because, in fact, this amendment is bigger news than the stuff that we initially highlighted when we cottoned on the day before you submitted these amendments last week that you were pulling a fast one and started to get the word out to the media and to the public that you were up to no good and that you intended to smuggle through essentially a new bill on water charges in a bill that when it was initiated in this House had nothing to do with water charges. But in the very short time we had to scan it and work out precisely what is in this bill and spotted some of the measures which you knew were going to be controversial and started to get it out there over the weekend, I have to admit I didn't spot this one. It's only more recently I've spotted it. And this is actually the worst one. This is the most controversial. And of course, that's why you did it. Because you knew this would be controversial and you sought to hide it and smuggle it in under another bill. Because this extends the situation which has absolutely infuriated people. That the property tax that was unfair and regressive and unjust and which people resisted, as if all that wasn't bad enough, is then going in to finance Irish water. And the motor tax that people paid. Precisely the issues which have driven people onto the streets in unprecedented numbers was going in to finance Irish water, so you pay through the neck with a regressive tax to finance a new utility that's going to make you pay through the neck for another regressive tax. But that was supposed to be for 1 year, and now you're extending it to a second year in breach of a previous commitment. I don't think most people know that. €500 million we're talking about here. This is big money. And when Deputy Stanley listed out, and Deputy Murphy, sorry, also listed out the various sources of finance for Irish water, motor tax, local property tax, raiding, stealing money from the loan parents in the social protection budget, and squeezing and trying to terrorise householders, they missed out one other source of finance, which is costing us all. And that is the fact that this is all on balance sheet, i.e. the state is borrowing extra money and paying interest to do this. An issue that was confirmed to me by the Fiscal Advisory Council, who pointed out that our deficit is increased by the costs of Irish water. So the government, who has savaged people in the name of reducing the deficit, the demand of the Troika, doesn't mind increasing the deficit and increasing borrowing and the interest we have to pay in order to set up Irish water. Which is really exposes what you guys are up to. Oh yeah, it's all meeting the targets, deficit reduction, reducing the debt, when it comes to justifying the assault on working people. But when it comes to setting up Irish water to squeeze people, to enrich contractors like Dennis O'Brien, no problem. We can inflate the deficit and pay the interest on it. And what the Fiscal Advisory Council made clear, if there be any doubt at all that you guys will be required to ratchet up the charges to two or three times or four times their current level, it was confirmed by the Fiscal Advisory Council, not a left-wing think tank by any means. An oversight body of economists set up by the Troika and established in law by yourselves. And they confirmed that to reduce the deficit, Irish Water is going to have to generate more money itself. And that means ratcheting up the charges as soon as you can get over the line, if you can get over the line of the next general election. So that's what you're up to. That's what you're up to with these amendments. That's what you've been up to with your entire strategy of dealing with the fury and anger and protest against these unjust charges is just mislead. I'm not allowed to say lie, so I'd say deliberately, cynically mislead, hide, deny, cover up your real intent, because you know exactly where this is heading. And it is heading to 600-700 euro a year, which you'll be required to do as part of the deficit reduction plan that you're committed to. And that, in fact, you will be under pressure from the Troika to meet. But this year, we're going to be borrowing more and spending more in order to finance this monster, which is Irish Water, to put the squeeze on ordinary people. And by the way, I should say to Deputy Stanley, I take the point, and he, of course, is absolutely right, when he says that people, when they're paying their utility bills, don't expect that the money will be going into financing a quango and so on, although we will just add to that as a footnote, that actually we do that when we pay our electricity bills. We do, with the public service obligation, which is going, much of it, into the hands of private companies in the so-called wind energy business. It's not actually going to produce energy for us, if you like. It's going to make profits for the private sector. So in that sense, Irish Water is completely consistent with what you guys are doing, which is the setting up of various utilities or trying to channel and funnel money into the pockets of private companies or entities that you hope soon will be private. And just, Minister, to respond to your attempt to justify all this in terms of the manner in which you have brought this in, and your denial, if you like, that you've been playing fast and loose with the democratic process, and your quoting of the words that Anne Phelan spoke in relation to these amendments at the committee stage. What you omitted to quote, or to mention, first of all, was the fact that she said it at the end of the committee stage, when it was over, so there's no chance of discussing the matter. And secondly, she said that the amendments would be published in good time. In good time. They were not published in good time, Minister. As soon as it became clear to me and in our office, and I'm sure other deputies were the same, that apparently technical amendments to do with water were going to be brought forward, I started to ring the Bills office. Where are the amendments? No sign of them. I kept ringing. Coming up to the morning of the deadline for our amendment, the final deadline for report stage, where are the amendments? Can we see the government amendments? We get to 11 o'clock, the deadline by which we have to have our amendments in. Can we see the government amendments? No. We didn't see them until mid-afternoon, after the deadline had passed for us. Now, if these issues, as you said, were well flagged, by the way, I have to congratulate your spin doctors on that one, because you managed to get every single correspondent to repeat that phrase. On RTE, Irish Times, a lot of them, they all repeated it. It was straight from your press release into the national media. Well flagged was the expression. But I asked the question, if it was so well flagged, why didn't you put it into the original bill? Because you obviously had it. You knew exactly what you were going to do. Are you saying that this thing that was so well flagged since the end of last year that you didn't bother to draft the legislation until when? Last Thursday? When was it finished? When was the legislation actually physically drafted? Maybe we should put in an FOI on that to find out when was it actually physically drafted? Could you answer that, Minister? Because it had to have been drafted some considerable time before the deadline of 11 o'clock last Thursday, or the vast majority of it. It was a fast one. You know it was a fast one. That's why you're smiling there, Minister. That's why Paul Keogh said last week when this was pointed out to him, he said, you want to get up in the morning to fool, early in the morning to fool you lot, with a big smile on his face. It was all a bit of a laugh that we were doing this, that we were playing a trick on the Dáil and on the public. You see, and maybe that's the way business has been done in here for years. I'm only in here for the last 4 years. And I'm not having fun when I see this stuff, Michael. You see, it's not fun scrambling around trying to figure out what's in legislation only to discover that we are extending one of the most controversial aspects of what you lot have done over last year, the fact that property tax money and motor tax money is going into Irish water. That's not funny. That is one of the, honestly, you talk to people on the demonstrations and ask them, what are the issues that have really angered and infuriated you? And that is the one that will come up most often, or certainly very near the top of the list. And then we discover that yous are going to do it again this year when you said you weren't. €500 million. Right? That is news, in my opinion. And was that well flagged? When did you know that? When did you decide that, Minister? And why couldn't we see the legislation relating to that before last Thursday afternoon, after the final deadline had passed? Because you were pulling a fast one. There is no other explanation. And I think people out there actually take these matters seriously. I mean, maybe in years gone by, people just dismissed the Dáil generally. But in the last few years, as we can see with what's happening in Greece, as we can see with the numbers of on the street, ordinary people are actually beginning to get very interested indeed, in the details of what goes on in here. And the more they look, the worse it gets. Games, games, games. All a big laugh, but we're actually playing with important stuff, very important stuff that affects the lives of human beings, affects the macro economy, affects all the big issues that are being debated now about debts and deficits, the very things that are leading to the big crisis in Greece. Does Angela Merkel know, I ask myself? Maybe she'll threaten to cut off the financing to our banks if she discovers we're inflating the deficit to line the pockets of Dennis O'Brien and the other contractors who are making money out of Irish water. So, Minister, this is just another example, but a big one, of what yous have been up to in trying to subvert the democratic process, and it is a disgrace. I mean, if you are honestly saying that this stuff doesn't need to be forensically debated at committee stage, something we won't get the chance to do, because you can't do what we do in committee in this sort of chamber, where we get a proper back and forward, and we can ask you questions, and we can say, yeah, what about this? And we can double check it, and then we get time to go back and look at those answers and then come back at report stage. That's what committee stage is for, right? That's the whole point of it. And you have circumvented that absolutely deliberately. And if you don't think so, Minister, you know, what would, if anybody suggested, honestly, if anybody suggested that we should, in terms of legislation generally, just get rid of second stage and committee stage and just everything had one stage of debate in the Dáil, wouldn't we be up in arms? Wouldn't anybody who believes in democracy and believes in the purpose of this chamber say that is utterly, utterly unacceptable? But yous did that with this bill deliberately. Deliberately, and you've done it with the IBRC stuff, but you did it deliberately. And I'll just conclude, Cathaoirleach, not that I've actually, I feel like going on forever just to annoy yous, right? Because you've played so fast and loose with the whole process. But that is why people are out on the streets. And you are fundamentally undermining people's belief in the democratic process. And, you know, when Deputy Shatter gets up there and gives out about it and refers disgracefully to fascists, right, unbelievable language, really outrageous that he should have been forced to withdraw. But if he wants to understand why people get angry, why do people get angry, why do they lose faith in the democratic system, it's because of that kind of carry-on. Right? So you're digging the grave for the very democracy or the type of democracy that you guys purport to care so much about. And it's playing with fire. So I think about this kind of thing, Minister, although frankly you seem to be so inured to this cynicism in this House, it's probably pointless even making these points.